is Murray going at it with Antoski. As Antoski's off the bench, and Antoski gets the right hand free, and he connects with some of the left in sight. Now the right's over the top, and Murray's in a bit of trouble here. Helmet is already knocked off. Antoski trying to line him up for another couple here. They now wrestle and spin each other around. Now Murray trying to get the right free. Antoski another right in tight. Now Murray over the top with the right, getting the back of Antoski's helmet. And now Murray with a right cross that may have caught him. Murray almost completely stripped now, showing a lot of a game attitude here as he sticks in there. But Antoski another right, and they're letting him fight. This one, another right. Oh, another right by Antoski. And now Murray back with a right, and away they continue to go. Murray now trying to pin Antoski as the linesman think about getting in there, and finally they'll break it up. And that was a true heavyweight battle. Murray pretty enthusiastic about his job as he has a couple of words for Shel Samuelson on his way to the Canadian penalty bench area.
Well, he did a lot of that in the American Hockey League, and that was the reason that Murray was called up. And it didn't take long for the combatants to go at it.
And Desjardins the point. LeClaire, Lindros, Otto up front. Devoted to Desjardins, the rush. Flyer player knocked down and injured behind the play. Penalty has been called, and Svoboda is in a very awkward... He's bleeding seriously out on the ice. Wow, they got to get him some help as Peter Svoboda is leading heavily. And Lindros has had enough. He's going after Brisebois. And they are rushing over.
I did not see the play.
He's not awake. Peter is not awake right now.
Did he hit his head on the ice?
I don't know, but this is a scary situation here. As John LeClaire is rushing over. They're getting the stretcher right away. One of the attendants just fell down too, going out and having a little trouble getting back up, but this place is very quiet. As you can see, Peter did not appear to be conscious. There are, of course, doctors on hand. In fact, doctors are being taken out right now to tend to Peter Svoboda along with the Flyers training staff. We'll be back in just a moment.
What you're going to see now is not very pleasant. After Peter Svoboda gets rid of the puck, he's watching the play, and he takes an elbow in the head, and his head will hit the ice.
It was Mark Bureau, who, if I have anything to say about it, will be suspended for the rest of the year for that shot. That is what you call a cheap shot.
Now, the play had already passed.
Right.
And there is a lot of concern as the team huddles around.
This is a
fine.
Yeah, this is, we obviously now are not going to guess anything. There are several doctors out there working on Peter Svoboda. Of course, all arenas are well equipped with doctors and, of course, all the equipment that you need to take care of emergencies. We have been told that it's a 5-minute major for elbowing, but not a game misconduct on Bureau. And what Don Van Massenhoven is doing by not giving him a game misconduct is opening up a can of worms when he hits the ice again later in this game. Because you know Philadelphia Flyers are not going to really, they're going to try to go after him, quite simply. Why he is not out of the game with that cheap shot, he's trying to say that
he hit it with
his shoulder. But
give me a break.
I mean, the tape doesn't lie. Mark Bureau is as guilty as can be on this one. Terry Murray is trying to look on. Van Massenhoven right now describing things to Desjardins and Antoski. Of course, the major concern now, though, is the condition of Peter Svoboda. Some fans are clapping, so perhaps, you know, we can't really tell. Peter is
moving. From this position, no. Oh, that is so scary. You know, even with the helmet on.
Well, he was unconscious, and now we get a look at him a little bit there.
Well, when Peter had made the play, he was watching the pass. He did not see Bureau come in.
His hands are moving, we're told.
I believe I can see one of the hands in there that is moving, so there is some motion, which is one of the first things you worry about. And that is obviously a good sign. As the doctors continue to tend to him, they obviously get him very quickly out to the hospital and give Peter the attention that he certainly needs. And we will try to get a report to you as soon as we can. While Odelein goes over to talk to Bureau, I'll tell you, this if Bureau hits the ice again in this game, it could get real nasty. I don't know why you don't give him a game. It's kind of almost... Not that we're really worried about Mark Bureau at this particular moment, but it's just opening up a whole other situation later in this game. Crowd now beginning to cheer as they are moving Peter Svoboda ever so slightly onto the...
And there's a stretcher. Conversation going on now with Terry Murray and Massenhoven to be able to listen to that conversation. But I'll tell you what, Jimmy, that's the hardest hit. One of the all-time cheap shots that I've ever seen in hockey.
And, you know, I believe, although it's hard to tell because he almost did look like he was out on the way down, but I think it's probably the head hitting the ice that did most of the damage. But it's hard to tell because he really did get popped, too, by the elbow.
Yeah,
so.
See, he had no way of protecting himself because he didn't see it coming.
And it was well after the pass. I mean, Jero had at least two strides to hit Svoboda after the pass had been delivered. And you can see the concern etched on the face of the Flyers players. Peter Svoboda now being taken off on the stretcher. Good hand from the crowd. And as I said, we will try to get you a report as soon as possible. Terry Murray continues to be pretty adamant in trying to make a point to Van Massenhoven. And Flyers majority owner Ed Snyder had actually gone down to the bench as well to check out things. And again, we'll try to get you a report. The crowd cheering for Peter Svoboda. Boy, that is a scary thing. Here's a penalty call. 5 minutes, folks. No game misconduct.
I don't know why Mark Bureau is shaking his head. It's almost as if he's in disbelief that a penalty is called against him.
Well, he'll be in disbelief when he gets out on the ice later in this game. Here's a look a little
now,
closer.
Peter passes it, and he's watching his pass. And in comes Bureau and throws that elbow.
Oh, boy. He's trying to say that that wasn't intentional. I don't know. But, and now the sticks and gloves are up all over the place. Otto involved with Fitzpatrick. Malakoff and Podine are wrapped up. Fitzpatrick now trying to throw punches. Now Malakoff and Podine are going to go. Malakoff and Podine spinning around. Podine tries a right, but he fell down. And then Malakoff wraps up. They get back up. Linesmen are breaking up the other one. So these two will continue to fight, or will they? Now they spin away and size each other up. Van Massenhoven will step in between them. And so that'll be the end of that. Otto has already been escorted off with Fitzpatrick in the penalty bench. And now Koivu grabs Desjardins. And Murray begins to trade shove. Murray, it'll be his second fight. He's got the right arm top. Flat trying to get his right arm free. Murray's already without his helmet again. He's seen a lot of his mugs here this evening. Now Murray a right cross. Flat can't get his right hand free. Another right by Murray. I'm not sure if that one hit, and now he takes him down into the corner. Fitzpatrick will go off for the Canadiens. Platt on with Otto and Podine, most likely for the Flyers.
It certainly is heating up. Now Murray always has a smile on his face. He's been involved in two majors now.
Yeah, Ron Hextall is certainly giving him some lip service. We've seen this before, but a good opposing linesman let up a little bit and lead to some pushing and shoving. Instead, this time they get him all the way off, and he heads to the Canadiens' locker room.
Now that's why he's in the lineup. Murray for the Montreal Canadiens. It's some good work by Klatt as he is hacked from behind and in front. Koivu wrapping him up. And this puck almost trickles through the pad of Jablonski. Joel Otto got a poke at it.
Vladimir Malakhov has also been escorted to the Canadiens' locker room. Flyers players. Klatt has been set off. Otto still in the penalty. Time running out on period number two. And here's McTavish now.
Euro.
And McTavish jumps him and gets the right hand free and then gets several other right hands in before the linesman gets there. And McTavish is still hammering away. Oh, not a very good job by the linesman of breaking it up. Not that we're really too upset about it, because Euro, it deserves to be punished a little bit. And McTavish got a lot of rights in. And that one, he's at the left-hand free now. But Craig McTavish, maybe 37 years old, but he's got plenty of fire. And he wants to protect and tell Marcio that the Flyers won't stand for what happened if he loses the vote. And now Van Massenhoven will have more calls to make. Euro gets up now and has some words. Roy McTavish. Crowd giving Euro the treatment as he heads off the ice. Next call, some more lip service for a Canadiens player on his way out. And the crowd now cheering for McTavish as he heads off.